the right place at the right time today. So let's all stand and be excited to worship the Lord and give our full attention to Him today. Set aside all your worries and just enjoy the presence of God. Now come on, tell the person beside you, you are at the right place at the right time. Okay, let me read to you first Psalm 18:30 to 33. God's way is perfect. All the Lord's promises prove true. He is a shield for all who look to Him for protection. For who is God except the Lord? Who but our God is a solid rock? God arms me with strength and He makes my way perfect. Thank you, Lord. God is telling you today, my child, there's nothing to worry about. There's nothing to fear. I am here. I love you, my son and daughters. I have a perfect way for you. Come on, let's all raise our hand and pray to the Lord and worship the perfect God. Father God in heaven, we thank you, Lord, that you are perfect. Nothing like you, God. Nothing compares to you, God. Your ways are perfect and your promises are true. Thank you for your faithfulness, oh God. Today we come to you in the name of Jesus. We humble ourselves before you, Lord. Lord, we need your presence. We want your presence, oh God. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. We want more of you, God. Have your way on us today, oh Lord. Lord, in your presence, Lord, there's freedom. In your presence, there's healing, oh God. Only in your presence, Lord, we find peace. We find true love, oh God. So Lord, make over, Lord God. Stay in our presence. Dwell in us today, oh God. Lord, we honor you.
Let us lift our hands. Oh, Spirit of God, we welcome you in this place, God. Let worship arise. Yeah, let worship arise. Yeah. You are calling me again. I hear your voice on the wind. In the quiet, in the still heaven, glory riven in the sky. The turning of the seas, echoes of your majesty. Heaven, and all that you have done,
For the streams of water. So I long for you, O God. Oh, I thirst for the living God. When can I go and stand before Him? Oh, we thirst for you, God. Oh, come on, let's show our desperation to Jesus this morning. Desperate God, we're desperate for your presence. Go back to the beginning. Can't control what tomorrow will be, but I know here in the middle is a place where you promised to be. Unless you come, will you meet me here again? Cause all I want is all you are. Will you meet me? sun shaping the shadow.
My heart and my soul. wonderful to see all of you. Just before you sit down, can you turn to three people? Help me welcome them. You know, you may give them a distant high five, a wave, or a smile, and then you may sit down. Whoa-hoo! Praise God. It's a happy Sunday morning, and we're just so glad to have you come to Lighthouse Christian Fellowship, your church, your home, and your family. And this is a church who loves God and who loves people, and we take to heart and we take seriously the great commission of God. Praise God. And so it's a joy to welcome everyone who's with us today in our first worship celebration. We also would like to welcome all those who are joining us online. Thank you for tuning in to our worship celebration. Stay tuned until the end of the service. God has a word for you today, and God has a refreshing for His people, a manna word for His people. And so to everyone who's with us today, whether physical or online, keep your heart open to the Lord and receive as much as God wants you to receive today. Praise God. All right, when you entered, you were given a newsletter. And I would like to highlight some of our announcement. Firstly, we have an event for the young people this coming Friday, July 22. Praise God, as WOW Generation brings to you F2F, Mindset Ba, Mindset. So I think these are the common lies that we have in the young generation today. Now, this one is a special gathering. We're having a face-to-face physical gathering right here at Cinema 6 of Victoria Plaza. And, you know, we prepared a timely message for our young people. There will be powerful testimonies, creative presentations, fun games with prizes, and dynamic praise and worship. And this is one event you wouldn't want to miss. And so please help us spread the word around that the young generation are for the Lord. Here at Lighthouse, we want to disciple the young generation to be followers of the Lord Jesus Christ. And so join our squad games and follow us on WOW Generation Youth FB page for more details. Praise God. By the way, the time of our WOW Generation party is 5:45 to 7:30 in the evening. Stay tuned if there will be an adjustment to this time. Praise God. Also, we are so excited for our upcoming in-house church training, which we call Ignite Leadership Training. Amen. So Pastor Lathur and I are preparing hard for this. A few weeks ago, we have Catch the Vision Training. And this is a sequel to that Ignite Leadership Training. This is happening on July 24, right after all the three services from 3 p.m. to 7 p.m. in the evening here at Cinema 6. And this is the time to sharpen our vision and grow in our service to the Lord. And so receive practical and biblical information from your pastors on how we can effectively lead people to Christ. Praise God. So for this Ignite Leadership Training, everyone is welcome. You know, if you come to this church, if you are in any way connected to this church, in the life group, or you attend our services, this is open to you. No, so also, if you are a life group leader, make sure that you bring the whole team, bring the whole squad to our Ignite Leadership Training. Praise God. And that's not it. There is more. Say it with me. There's more. Praise God. On August 5, that is a Friday, we will have another Lighthouse Family Summit. And this is happening 6:30 to 8:50 in the evening right here at Cinema 6, another face-to-face gathering. And this will be a special training on the power of invitation. How we can effectively bring people into the kingdom of God, invite them to our events. And aside from Pastor Lathur and I, who will be sharing, we have also invited Mr. Jim Faubert to help us with this. And so, wow, we have a lot of things in store for the church. This is training time, and we believe that all this training will redound to the glory of God and the advancement of His kingdom. And so, just a reminder to everyone, we continue with our online prayer meetings every Thursday, 7:30 to 8:30 in the evening. And you know, too many soldiers of God, of the army of God, has gone AWOL, no? So absence without leave. And so this is the time to stir up and ignite more people to pray. Praise God. So if you have time on a Thursday, be there, attend our online prayer meeting. And lastly, reminding everyone to please share our online audio and video materials on social media. If you have friends who can benefit from our Sunday worship services, please send them a link of our audio and video materials. And also continue to support our resources. Like, comment, share. You know, let's make Jesus viral in the social media. Let's make the presence of God viral on social media. So that's about it. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, church. It's time to give. Now, but before that, let me exhort to you the verse in Proverbs 3:5-6. It says here, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your path straight." Now, I believe every one of us here already know that we are commanded to give. That's in Malachi 3:10. If you can read in the envelope, it says there, no, we are to give, we are to bring the whole tithe in the storehouse. No, sa kay Lord, ihatag na to ang tenth. Now, our giving of tithes and offering greatly requires trusting God and relying on Him in everything. But sometimes, no, we tend to analyze things. Meron po tayong mga, no, before we give, nagakalculate, all right, Lord, what will happen to my rent? Will I be able to pay for my rent, for my bills? Lord, nana si Judith, andito na si Juna. What will I eat? And a lot of other concerns. But you know what? God knows we cannot depend on ourselves in our capacity for our to be provided, no, para sa ato ang mga needs. We need help. We need help from the Lord. Now, giving our tithes, besides obeying and honoring God, it is also acknowledging that God is sovereign over our finances. Now, when we say God is sovereign over our finances, we say that He is in control. Now, so when you obey Him today, now let's give our full trust to Him. And then just believe and really know that we can trust God to take care of us. Now, who believes that? Now, the Lord will take care of our needs. Now, today we also have a lot of opportunities to give besides our tithes and offering. So may I just request everyone to stand. And let's just raise our envelope, no? And let's just declare the blessing of God in our giving. Let's pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we just want to thank You for this great opportunity to bless Your name, to honor You, to obey You, and to even, oh God, Lord, trust You completely in everything. And Lord, thank You so much, oh God, for how You are providing for our needs and even beyond our needs, Lord. Salamat that You see our heart's desire. Salamat that You, oh God, Lord, knows everything that we need, oh God. And so, Lord, thank You for greatly providing for everyone. We give You glory, honor, and praise for what You are going to accomplish in our giving. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's give.
For Lighthouse Online Family, we encourage the faithful giving of tithes and offerings. Giving channels are as follows. You may do a bank deposit in the following branches with the account name, The Lighthouse Christian Fellowship. Union Bank, account number 10017003981. China Bank, account number 17225280 18. Metro Bank, account number 0583058628159. PNB, account number 40171000179. Kindly provide a copy of your deposit slip to the Lighthouse office for verification, or you can take a screenshot and send through Facebook Messenger either to Eva Daga Asbiliena or Catherine M. Fernandez. You may also give through GCash transfer using these numbers: 0998-158-2269 or 0918-213-1530. May God bless you richly as you faithfully give to our God.
You and I are called up by the Lord to love Him and love people. Together, let us do and support the missions. Let us receive the ministry of God's Word through the Lighthouse Senior Pastor, the man of God, Pastor Lathur Badoy.
Good morning. Can we all stand and clap our hands to the Lord? God, we honor you today. Lord, you're amazing. You're awesome. There's no one like you. Lord, we honor you today. And God, we open our hearts. Teach us, Lord. Change us, Lord. And send us out to do the great work you have planned for us to do. We thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Everyone would say, amen. You may be seated. God is good. Good morning, everyone. Magandang umaga po sa lahat, those joining us online. Magandang araw po sa ating lahat. God is so good. It's good to see you. As usual, we say that because it's true. We really enjoy the gathering of the people of God. Masaya ho na nandito tayo ngayon. So God, I know, will touch our lives as we give Him importance in our lives. Amen? You know, yan mo ang importante. So many people, they want to be blessed, but they want God out of the picture. They just want to use God to, you know, give them when some things when they are in trouble. But on the normal events of life, they don't really care. And if that's our attitude, God respects that. But we will not get the blessings of the Lord, the great blessings of God. So, but when we open hearts to God, seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, what is good and right. All the things we need will be given to us. And we will have that relationship with God which satisfies the most. And therefore, panalong panalo po tayo. Amen? Pero wag palapakan si Lord. God is great and God is good. And we want to honor God in all things. The message of the Lord today is entitled, You Are Called to Mission. You are called to mission. Can you turn to someone and tell that person, you are called to mission? All right. Now, some people, when it says mission, they want me to do something. I'm already very busy. Why are they wanting me to do something? Or they want me to feel bad so I will maybe give or pray or what? But, you know, I want to tell you from my heart, with all truth, as truthful as fully as I can, this is one of the most exciting topics, not only in the Bible, but in practical life. Alam niyo ho, yung mission ho, yan yung gusto talaga ni Lord gawin from the beginning. Hindi pa kapag niya ginawa, iyan ay yung gusto niyang gawin. In fact, Ephesians 2:10 says, 8 and 9 says, we are saved by grace through faith. And then it says there that He saved us for the good works that He planned for us before we were born. So hindi ka pa pinanganak, may plano na si Lord sa'yo. Amen? At yung plano na yun, hindi yun para lang umupo-upo dun sa beach ng Boracay at mag-enjoy-enjoy. You know, I say fun is great, but it's so overrated. So overrated. Napakaraming tao. You know, we just came from Dusitani. It's also a very good resort, okay? But the point is, after you get that, what's next? You get bored. Kaya ho uso ang drugs and alcohol because people are bored. But I don't take drugs. I don't take alcohol. I don't need to. I'm happy. I'm thrilled. I may adventure ako sa buhay. Amen? So when you enjoy the things of life, but you serve God as the passion of your life, panalong panalo ka. You honor God and your life is happy. So that's what we want to do. We want to honor God and also be happy. Amen? Amen. All right. So ito po ay pag-usapan natin. This is practical, but it's going to be, by the grace of God, good. So, i-define po muna natin what mission is. What mission is? Saving lost humanity and renewing them so that they are restored into the image of God, so they will worship and serve God. This is mission. So, that's my own words of describing mission. So, sa mission ho, we want people to find God. We want people to be restored in una yung connection nila kay God. Because if apart from the Lord, we are separated from Him because of sin. But after we come to that relationship, we are forgiven, we become sons and daughters of God, kailangan natin ma-renew or mabago, okay? Mabago ang isip natin, mabago ang puso natin, mabago ang lifestyle natin. So we are to be matured like Christ. And how do we become matured? by growing in godliness as we fellowship with God through our daily devotion and prayer and with the people of God through Sunday gatherings and life groups and so on. Now, this is true. What this mission is true in same culture and different culture settings. So, baka yung iba sa inyo, hindi nyo masyadong ma-picture out mission pa. Ano, pupunta ako sa bukid, sa ibang bansa? Well, merong ding mission na same culture, meaning kapareho natin, and therefore, pwede rin tayong ma-involve doon. Same culture mission is sharing the goodness of forgiveness of sins and reconciliation with God to people of the same or similar customs, language, and cultural characteristics. So, for example, katong isa ka Bisaya, or Tagalog, for our Tagalog audience, we'll go to Bisaya or Tagalog people and share the gospel to them. So, same culture. Ang salita, nagkakaintindihan tayo, yung ating mga paraan, the way we live, most likely same-same or similar. Therefore, we can understand each other. So, mission yun when we do that, to share the gospel of Jesus. Now, ano yung different culture mission? Different culture mission is sharing the gospel to people of a different culture, whether in the same country or not. So, for example, Abisaya, okay, we'll go to the mountains of Chiang Mai in northern Thailand to a tribe, let's say the Lathur tribe, and then I will share the gospel to them. So, yung lingwahe namin iba, yung mga paraan namin, itsura namin siguro iba, pagkain namin iba, etc. So, different culture mission, but it's all mission. We're bringing the gospel of Jesus to people who need it. Matthew 28, 18 to 20 says, then Jesus came to them, to his disciples, to you and to me today, he's speaking the same words, and said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the very end of the age. This passage is commonly called the Great Commission, not commission sa networking, but commission na orders, instructions. It's like a military term. This is what you are to do, to accomplish. That's the mission order, kumbaga. And this is what is very, very important in the heart of God. Sabi nila, people's last words are usually the most important to them. And in a way, it's true. Kaya nga, kung mamamatay na isang tao, ipatawag yung mga anak, patawag mo yung mga family, yung pinakalapang sabihin yun ang pinaka-importante, di ba? Say, okay, kayo ganito ha, huwag kayong mag-away-away. Magmahalan kayo, magsuportahan kayo. At yung mga lupa na yan, ha, ihati-hati nyo yan, be fair, be kind to one another. Basta yung mga last na sinasabi, yun ang pinaka-importante. Tama ba? Alright? So, ganun din si Jesus, just before he ascended to heaven, he said this word. So, importante po ito. Okay? Pwede mo sabihin yung katabi mo kung may katabi ka and those online as well. Importante ito. Okay? Importante ang Great Commission, and those are the words of Jesus. So, Jesus wants to be proclaimed in all the world so people can be saved. Pwede mong maligtas ang tao apart from Jesus? Well, the answer of the Bible is no. It cannot. It cannot happen. They cannot be saved apart from Jesus. The Bible says, Acts 4:12, there is no name under heaven except the name of Jesus by which people can be saved. That's the truth. And other people may say, well, I don't believe that, but that's what the Bible says, and we believe it's true. That's why we go out and share, because people need the Lord and people need the Word of God. So we do missions because people need the Lord. Let's help in accomplishing needed strategic advancements in mission. Sa mission po, kumakalat naman po ang Word of God, ang Gospel, the goodness of salvation through Jesus sa buong mundo. However, marami pa pong areas na hindi pa na-penetrate. So, yun ang sabi natin, strategic advancements na kailangan. So, lahat ng mission, whether dito sa downtown, no, dito sa poblasyon Davao City, or you go to Burma, or you go to some part of Ethiopia maybe, or some African country, some other African country, it's the need is there, but there are places where the need is greater. No? So, yung spiritual hunger and need is greater in some areas than in others. So, we call this frontier mission. Frontier meaning out there, dun sa mga lugar na wala pa masyadong nakarating or nakapunta. Frontier mission is reaching the unreached people groups, or UPGs we call them. Unreached people groups are people or tribes na hindi pa na-penetrate ng gospel, okay? So sila po ay hindi pa ho napasukan ng a strong influence of the gospel, and therefore there is a greater need in their locality and among their tribe. So sa Philippines po, according to official statistics, there are 13 unreached tribes, 13. And they are all Muslim tribes. So doon, meron ng believers, pero napaka-konti. Hindi nila kayang i-reach ang kanilang tribe. So, therefore, we say frontier yon or unreached. At gusto nating pumasok doon kasi doon ang pinaka-grabe ang pangailangan. Para bang yung feeding program, for example, kasi spiritual food, physical food. Di ba nung nagbagyo, for example, doon sa may Surigao, etc. No? So, Agusan. So, you want to bring food. Pero in a way, maganda unahin mo yung pinaka-desperado. Yung wala talagang nagdadala ng tulong. Kasi sila ang pinaka-grabe ang need. So, parang ganun po ang idea ng frontier mission. And we want to be involved in that. Now, according to the Joshua Project, the flagship ministry for reaching the unreached peoples of the world, there are over 7,400 unreached people groups in the world. Out of the 17,446 unique people groups in the world. Pag sinabi yung people group, these are people who share common language, customs, common ways of, you know, living, ang kanilang lifestyle are common. The 7,400 plus unreached people groups can account for 41% of the world's population. So, marami pa po. Okay? Kaya nga nung pandemic, some people were saying, well, it's good we're able to preach the gospel everywhere because online. And I say, no, no, no. The unreached are in the farthest places where there's no internet and no one goes there. And, you know, it's illegal maybe, or it's so dangerous, etc. So, we need to do mission tuloy-tuloy. Kaya ngayon, they may be saying, bakit natin pinag-uusapan ito? Because the Lord loves those people, amen? The Lord loves those people, everyone, e lalo na yung grabing pangailangan, and the Lord wants us to be involved. And that's why we're talking about it, so we can do something. Okay, so frontier mission, that's what we want. So, as you know, in Lighthouse, in years past, when yung hindi pa nag-lockdown, we were sending mission teams to Thailand, Myanmar, Laos. We send a team, for example, to Malaysia, and nag-minister tayo doon, or not. We try to do whatever we can within the legal framework. Because Malaysia is an Islamic country, but there were people there from Afghanistan, Bangladesh, yung mga Rohingya, people from Syria, and so on. It's also on my part, nagturo ako sa may border ng Laos. So what happens is Christians in the northern part, border of Thailand and Laos, they're being asked to cross over to Thailand on the border, and then my Bible training school dun tapos. Tinuturuan sila how to do the ministry. They already have churches, but kulang sila ng training. So I went, you sent me, thank you, Lighthouse sent me to teach, etc. Napaka-exciting po noon. I also went to Mandalay in Myanmar, Burma, and taught. And some of the trainees, pastors, missionaries there also minister. Yung iba doon na sa may border ng India and Myanmar. So we do these things. Even here locally, we are involved sa Tinananon tribe, Matigsalog tribe. When this bagyo sa Surigao and so on, we sent help more than once doon sa Mamanwa tribe, sa may certain part of Surigao, etc. So those are some of our involvements in all of these things. We cannot mention too many. Pero yung frontier mission ay mahalaga, and we want us to pray and be involved here. Romans 15:20 says, sabi ni Apostle Paul, inspired by the Holy Spirit, it has always been my ambition to preach the gospel where Christ was not known, so that I would not be building on someone else's foundation. Rather, as it is written, those who were not told about him will see, and those who have not heard will understand. Okay? Now, why are we talking about frontier mission? Kasi naman po, okay naman yan. Mamaya, paglabas dito, kumain ka ng food court, share ka ng gospel sa ibang tao, fine, that's great. Same culture mission, same culture ministry. Okay po yun. What we're simply saying is, merong iba na talagang, kumbaga, talagang desperate talaga ang need doon. Para bang sa feeding or ayuda, iba na kailang rounds na. Iba kahit isa, wala pa. Sino ang mas nangangailangan? Yung hindi pa talaga nakatanggap. Amen? Parang ganun po ang idea ng frontier mission. So we want to think about that and we want to be involved in that. Mark 1:38, Jesus replied, "Let us go somewhere else to the nearby villages so I can preach there also. That is why I have come." Sabi ni Jesus, "Wag lang parati dito. Doon lang sa mas malayo yung hindi pa tayo nakapreach. Punta tayo doon. Punta tayo doon." Amen. Let's contribute to the harvest of individuals and nations that God desires. So ito po, you and I, tinawag tayo ni Lord, hindi lang ho para ma-save, kundi para ho maging instruments ng salvation sa iba. So you and I are called by God to go out and be involved, to sometimes just stay here but do something for the harvest of individuals and nations that God desires. Alam niyo po, si Jesus, sabi sa Bible, He is in heaven on the right hand of the Father. Okay, so siya yung kumbaga implementor, CEO sa langit. But among other than ruling heaven, He also is praying or interceding. Nagpe-pray si Jesus. And He's praying, among other things, for His people, but also for, I believe, for the lost. John 10:16, sabi ni Jesus, "I have other sheep." Say, other sheep. "Other sheep that are not of the sheep pen. I must bring them also. They too will listen to my voice, and there shall be one flock and one shepherd." Okay, now, in context, yung original context, then it was referring to the Gentiles. So yung Jews were trying to follow Him, merong iba, the Gentiles. But the same principle applies kahit sino. The point is, merong nakapasok na at merong hindi pa. Okay? Yung hindi pa nakapasok, yun ang gusto ni Jesus, mapasok din sila. Amen? Gusto nating tumulong po. Gusto nating ma-involve sa mission where people of different backgrounds can hear and receive the word of God. Matthew 24:14, "And this gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all the nations, and then the end will come." So gusto ni Lord is ma-preach po ang gospel sa buong mundo. Hindi lang sa mga metropolitan areas, hindi lang po sa mga, you know, prosperous or safe places, but even in the unsafe and uncomfortable places. So later I'll show you a video of some of our trips. When we go to Thailand, Laos, Myanmar, mission, for example, we usually go to the border places, okay? Kasi po doon una, wala masyadong pumupunta. Okay? Kasi awa-awa na to, delikado din doon, okay? To be honest, so there was one time that the town locked down, they locked down militarily, okay? But we were already on our way out. So nakalabas kami. If we stayed for 3-4 more hours, we would have been locked in kasi may upcoming parang military encounter daw. Now that doesn't always happen. But the point there is, I'm trying to be truthful to you, when you go on frontier mission, sometimes may element of risk yan. Pero huwag kang mag-worry kasi tutulungan ka naman ni Lord. Amen? Tsaka just to be very honest, if it's time for you to go, ba't mo gusto mo mag-overstay? Amen? I want to go to heaven when it's my time to go. But I also subscribe to what John Wesley, the great British evangelist, said, "You are immortal until your mission is complete." Habang di patapos ang mission mo, di ka mamamatay. Amen? Yan ang paniwalaan natin para masaya, magaan ng buhay. Amen? Because we believe it's true. But anyway, God wants us to go and share the gospel in many, many places and in far away places as well. Revelation 7:9-10. Revelation 7 is a vision from God and it talks about the end of times. Doon ito sa dulo now. And it's not yet even now. It's still coming. And this is what the prophetic vision says. "After this, I looked, and there before me was a great multitude. Ang dami-dami ng mga tao that no one could count from every nation, tribe, people, and language. Standing before the throne and before the Lamb, they were wearing white robes and were holding palm branches in their hands. And they cried out in a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God who sits on the throne and to the Lamb." So dito nakita natin na duno ang mga tao from different nations and tribes. Okay, and so this is our desire to honor God, to fulfill the will of God. Amen? I want to say, kung tayo po ay Christian, we're supposed to be like Christ or following Christ. So kung ano yung ginagawa niya or gusto niya, yun ho dapat ang ating gusto. Amen? I'm not trying to make you feel uncomfortable or makonsyensya, but that is the reality, okay? What's the point na Pinoy ka? In everything, hindi ka naman Pinoy. Nililiginalibak mo pa ang mga Pinoy pag nandun ka sa kasama mo yung mga ibang klaseng mga nationality, people from other nationalities. If you're a Christian, then be a Christian. Amen? And Christians are involved in the Great Commission in various ways, prayer or whatever, pero meron tayong dream and desire that people from every nation, tribe, language will know the Lord, and they will grow in their relationship with God. That's our purpose, and that's our goal. Amen? Amen. All right. Next, say yes to your calling for mission. Say yes to your calling for mission. Now, why are we talking about that? Isn't everyone saying yes? And the answer is, no. Sadly, no. Most people are just comfortable, okay? Alam niyo po, like, you know, I say it every now and then. I hope it doesn't sound bad. I was not always a pastor. And there was a time I really had a wonderful career. I could be on my way to be a millionaire or whatever. Pero alam niyo po, masaya mag-serve kay Lord. Eh. Kaya serve lang ako hanggang naging pastor na ako. Okay? And I want to say to you, exciting po ito. Boring ho yung, you know, iniyom ka lang ng Starbucks ko, bakayin ka na kung ano-anong, pasyal ka doon. After a while, boring na po yan. I've met some jet-setting people in the world. You know, yung talagang grabe talaga, parang ang Hong Kong, para lang yung bangkirohan sa kanila, gaganon, punta doon ng umaga, uwi ng hapon, sa Manila ulit, mga ganon na, alam mo, napaka-boring ng buhay, sabi nila, nakapagod. Boring. Ang exciting yung mag-serve kay Lord. Thrilling ho talaga. Younger people, I want to say this is one of the most thrilling things you could ever be involved in. So maybe we all say yes to our calling for a mission. Isaiah 6:8. Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?" And He said, "Here am I, send me." Sana po ngayon, yan ang ating maging attitude and response. We hear the voice of God calling us. And then we say, "Yes, yes, Lord, here I am. Nandito po, send me." I say yes to you, God. I say yes. I say yes to you, Lord. So Lighthouse, we use hashtags like Lighthouse to the Nations. Yan po, it's one of our hashtags. Together we grow. Years ago, together we go. And other things. So these are very meaningful hashtags. So Lighthouse to the Nations. By the way, nations sa ating kultura is political entities, geographical entities. Pero sa Bible, or nations is ethnic characteristics. So, pwedeng nasa isang political, geographical area kayo, pero magkaiba kayo ng ethnic characteristics. Therefore, magkaibang nation kayo. But anyway, Lighthouse to the Nations means reaching tribes and peoples wherever they may be, and that's what we want to do. Together we grow. Gusto natin mag-grow tayo, but we also say, together we go. We want to go and be involved. And sa mission po, marami yung possible involvements. You can be a goer, as in physically going. You can be someone who prays. You can be a financer. And I tell you, this is one of the really important things because mission costs money. Magastos o mag-mission. But there are other skills as well na pwede pong magawa. Okay, so what can we do? So number one is, let us pray for mission. Can you say, pray for mission? Malaga po ito, okay? The proclamation of the gospel in any context is to be accompanied by prayer because hindi ho naman talaga natural sa isang sinner na ibigay ang buhay niya kay Lord. It takes the moving of the Holy Spirit. So you and I need to pray for mission na magkaroon ng maraming missionaries, maging effective sila, and people in the various places are gonna reach out, will open their hearts. Kailangan ho ng prayer, okay? So kahit nasa bahay ka lang, you know, pwede kang maging missionary by prayer. You can go to, you know, other, any place, name it, okay? You can go to Indonesia, the largest Muslim country in the world. You can go to Saudi Arabia. You can go to other places by staying here, but praying, okay? So prayer is very important. So right now, I want us to do a little bit of a practicum. Practicum kaagad, okay lang? Okay, we want to pray for Thailand because yung Thailand po is, among other things, nilagay ni Lord sa heart natin yan, but among other things, very strategic usa kasi Thailand is open and yet the neighboring countries are not. Myanmar, Laos, Vietnam, Cambodia. Cambodia is a bit open but not as open. So when you are welcome in Thailand, from there, para mag-guerrilla mission ka to the neighboring places. Okay, so we want to pray for Thailand. So can we show that, please? Okay, so ano po yung mga kailangan nating malaman about Thailand? Okay, quick facts. So yan po yung mga kanyang capital is Bangkok. Population is almost 70 million, etc. Next slide. Yung religion mostly Buddhist and so on. A population in unreached people, 88.2%. So, marami. Next. Ayan. So, ito ay pagpipray natin mamaya. Okay? So, can we show that? Okay. Pray for the gospel to effectively permeate this culture of Buddhism, Spiritism, and the occult. Pray for moral conviction to fall on those who oppress others for profit via the sex trade. Pray for explosive growth in the church to reach all the 80,000 villages. But hey, one of the things we did as a church, and we give glory to God, was we did an end-to-end travel from the border of Laos, yung sa may Sabanaket, ang tawag doon, Mukdahan. Sabanaket on Laos side, Mukdahan on the Thailand side, bridge lang, nag-gone, and then we went all the way to the other side, Mesot. Okay, so we crossed literally from kung saan yung pinakadulo, tapos yung sa pinakadulo, we did a journey there. Nag-pray tayo doon, hanggang doon sa Mesot, hanggang sa Muadi Bridge, na pagtawid mo lang noon, Myanmar na, Burma na, etc. So, napaka-exciting. But this is really, really, I tell you, younger people, think about it, pray about it. I tell you don't have to take drugs, drink alcohol, or anything. This is the most exciting thing. Pagod ka na maging bored, mag-mission ka, tintina mo. Sasaya ang buhay mo, etc. But now, let's pray for Thailand. So meron tayo ipi-play na prayer video. And ang process nito is habang nagpe-pray yun sa Thai, may English na translation, voice over, and then sabayan natin ngayon yung nagpe-pray in English. So let's pray together as we play the video.
Beloved Father, we thank you and praise you. We deeply desire to pray for Thai people. We give you thanks for the grace and love that you have demonstrated to us in so many different ways. We thank you for gospel which has entered Thailand and has been spreading throughout the land. We pray that your mercy would pour down over us as we preach the good news. We pray that every ear will hear the story of Jesus Christ and every knee will bow before you and that every tongue will confess that you are God. May your gospel bring forth abundance of fruit as it did preach in this land. Lord in heaven, there are so many sins that Thai people have committed. Lord, we ask for your mercy. Cleanse our spirit, that we would be able to forsake our sins. Forgive the condition of our heart that we would leave the sin of adultery that are so prevalent in our country. Having sex before marriage, rampant murder, human trafficking, and sinful lifestyles. Father, we ask that you would help us solve these problems. There are so many people addicted to drugs and alcohol and are trapped in their sins. So many people don't have a way out. May you enter into their dire circumstances and touch their life in a way that they will come to know you and see the light of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, the problem of corruption is so prevalent in our country. Help Thai people to be faithful and honest with one another. May they see Jesus, who is our faithful God. May you move mightily among the family of Thai Christians. That will be salt and light, that we will show you love, bring forth your salvation, and we will proclaim your name. May you lead us and call us to humble ourselves, that we will confess our sins. We believe that you will hear from heaven and heal our land. May you pour out Holy Spirit on this land. May you rid us of darkness in our heart and shine the light into Thai hearts. May you bless and heal us. We give you thanks and praise you. We pray together in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Can we clap our hands to the Lord? Amen. Can you tell someone near you, if that's possible, let's pray for mission. Amen. It's something that's very, very important. Number two is, let us support mission. Support mission. And by support, we mean not just financial, although that's very important, to be honest, but encouragement, okay? And other practical things that we can do. Importante ho ang pag-support ng mission. Practical services, for example, we can do when we do missions. Okay, so we ask you, okay, let's be involved. Ngayon po ang Thailand, beginning July 1st, we lifted na lahat ng restrictions. You don't need to show a vax card, a booster, proof that you're boosted. You don't need to show anything. Just have your passport and your ticket and you're in, okay? So pwede na tayong bumalik doon kung gusto natin, okay? Eh, sabi ko, Lord, sige Lord. Punta tayo, balik tayo ulit doon. At least once ngayong taon, 2022. But we need support when we do that. We need support financially. We need people. Imbis na ano ba yung kwan yung kasukasto niyan? To be encouraging and provide the practical services na kailangan. At maghanap ng siguro tickets na medyo mas mura ng konti or whatever. So we want to be involved. Let us support mission. Amen? Pakisabi ulit sa katabi mo, other side maybe, let us support mission. All right, number three is, for those who can go, by all means, go. Okay? By all means, go. So ito po, we want to be involved. Now, by the way, right now, kasi we're talking about Thailand because we have a guest, right, for the 11 service and the 1 p.m. service. But here in the Philippines, and here locally, we actually also are involved in tribes. And so, as pag lumuluwag yung restrictions, lumalabas po tayo. Pag medyo allowed na, etc., we are involved again. So, please, let's all think about being involved by going. Okay? Marami pa rin yung mga opportunities na gustong i-provide si Lord. So, locally, maybe, God willing, we can do one local trip na hindi lang date, you know, parang day tour kung magapunta ka, umaga balik ka ng hapon. Kung pwede overnight ulit, like we did before. Okay? So for those who are part of Lighthouse, there was a time we sent a team of about 100 people, nag-overnight kami in the mountains of Arakan. Amazing, naglakad kami ng 3 oras dahil na lubog yung masarakyan, hindi na makatakbo. By foot na lang, okay? For at least for some of us. Yung iba, nakaya naman. Later on, may rescue, etc. But napakasaya being involved in mission. So locally or abroad, we can go. You don't need to be the preacher. You can be the cook. You can be the pangkarga ng whatever. You don't need to be the actual evangelist. But you can be part of the team that is involved. So right now, I want us to watch a video ng isang mission trip ng Lighthouse in 2019, just before the pandemic came. And ito po, masaya. So, pumunta tayo ng Thailand and Laos and then Myanmar, Burma. And maraming na-involved dito. Masaya ho talaga. Napakasaya, I tell you. Amazing, amazing. Unforgettable, really. So, panoorin ho natin, may the Lord stir our hearts to be involved in going for mission. So, let's play and let's be inspired.
Let me hear the worshipers! because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
Every praise, every praise, every praise, every praise.
Can we clap our hands to the Lord? Saya-saya, di ba? And you don't need to be the preacher. You can be the dancer or the costume maker or whatever. Let's be involved, okay? This year, sabi ko, Lord, pwede ba atis isa biyahe tayo this year, okay? I-ready mo na ang passport mo. I was telling someone, i-renew mo na ang passport mo. Okay, anyway, so number four, a way we can serve and be involved is let's welcome persons from unreached nations and tribes, lead them to the Lord, train them, and send them back to their places as God's missionaries. So, for example, before we had medical students from India. They came in as Hindus and they found the Lord here and they joined the encounter. They took SL1, School of Leaders 2, School of Leaders 3, and now they're back in India. So hopefully they will be bringing the gospel with them and doing the ministry. But we can do that for other people. Kung I was once, you know, I love to play table tennis. I was once playing with someone and I noticed it was a foreigner. Sabi ko, you know, I'm from Russia. I'm an engineer from Russia. Alam ko lang ping pong. People from everywhere are everywhere. So talk to them, befriend them. They may be Tausug, they may be, you know, Nigerian, they may be whatever, from Saudi Arabia. Befriend people, share the gospel, and let them find the Lord, grow in the Lord. And when they go back to their places, they will be missionaries for the Lord. Amen? Amen. And then, number five, can we have the musicians now? Number five, we can do missionary care for missionaries in a needy and strategic area. So we can do missionary care. So ngayon po, for example, we have a family, kasi hindi ba tayo makapunta ngayon doon sa Thailand. At least July lang nag-open up eh. So we said, when we go there, we encourage, we refresh missionaries. So why don't we bring them here and do the same thing. The same din ang epekto nun. We listen to them. We pray for them. We encourage them. Same din yon. So missionary care, ginagawa natin. We do it abroad, but we also are doing it now. So if you can come for the 11 a.m. service, the Garcia family will be here. It's really wonderful that we are all involved in whatever way we can to support the mission purpose of God for our lives. Amen? Amen. So as I wrap up, masaya ho ang buhay pag ginagawa natin ang will ni Lord. Masaya ho, thrilling ang buhay pag tayo ho ay nagsiserve. And I tell you, mission is wonderful. I love, ako, if I'm single, I'll probably be there next week. I mean, if no one will suffer, if I die, then I will probably just do the mission. It's exciting and it's fulfilling. And of course, it honors God. But again, you won't die when your mission is not yet complete. God will protect you and you will have fun. You will enjoy the work because it is the will of God. And the will of God, according to Romans 12, 2, is good, pleasing, and perfect. Okay? So let's do mission. Let's be involved. And God will be glorified and many people will find the Lord. Amen? Palapakan po natin si Lord. Thank you, Lord God. Can we all stand, please? Tumayo po tayo lahat. Can we close our eyes? Can we raise our hands? This is so that we will not be distracted. Let's close our eyes so that we will, you know, be able to just receive from the Lord. If you can, you can raise your hands, even those joining us online. Come on, let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord God, for the beautiful, beautiful plan that you have made for us. In the name of Jesus, may we all embrace, Lord God, your missionary call. Not necessarily to be preachers, but Lord God, to be part of teams. Kahit kami lang yung magluluto, kaharga ng gamit, but God's available, or magpe-pray, or mag-financial support sa mission. Help us, God. Lord, forgive us aming pagkukulang. So forgive us for our neglect. Right now, we want to pick up the pieces and restore what is, you know, not completely lost, but humina na gusto, Lord, tulungan mo kami. Papalik namin to in the name of Jesus. Help us to be involved in mission. Come on, tell the Lord, God, help me to be involved in mission. Help me, Lord, to be involved in mission. I will pray. I will support. Lord, if, you know, kung okay lang, I'll go, etc. So help me, God. Help me, Lord. Help me, Lord. Help me, God. Come on, just keep praying to the Lord. Keep praying. But right now, for those who are joining us here face-to-face, those online, kung di mo pa nabigay ang buhay mo kay Lord, ito ang pinaka-importante. Kaya ako may mission kasi may mga taong hindi pa tama ang kanilang relationship kay God. And if you're here physically or you're joining us online, hindi tama ang relationship kay God. Alam mo disconnected kay God. Alam mo hindi kayo okay ni Lord. Give your life to God. Tell the Lord today, God, forgive me. Patawarin mo ako, Lord. And God, I pray, Lord, help me and change me. Lord, I surrender my life to you. Jesus, I trust you. Ngayon, gawin mo yan, wherever you are. Today, online, face to face, tell the Lord, God, forgive me. God, I'm sorry. God, reconcile me to you, God. I want to live for you and not for me. Change me, Lord. Forgive me, Lord God. And when you do, when you pray that English, Tagalog, whatever is your dialect or language, tell God, God, I'm sorry. Jesus, come into my heart. Change me. And when you repent and give your life to the Lord, God will be so gracious to forgive your sins. He will make you a child of God. So, Father in heaven, we pray, change us, Lord. Help us, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God. If you have a need or prayer request, would you please raise your hand? I want to pray the blessing of God over your life. If there's a need or prayer request, come on, let us pray. Lord, I pray, bless those who are raising their hands. Bless them financially, Lord God. Bless them, Lord, with good health. At kung merong sakit, heal them, God, or their family members. Lord, bless your work. Bless their business. Lord, help them sa kanilang studies, God. Lord, we pray, make them fruitful in their ministries. Bless them, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Everyone raise your hands for the final blessing as we are now about to be dismissed. Receive the blessing of the Lord before you go, even those joining us online. Receive the blessing of the Lord. And now may the Lord bless you and protect you. The Lord cause His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly, and the Lord bless you with His peace. In the name of Jesus we pray. Everyone would say, amen. And amen. Let's clap our hands to the Lord. Thank you so much. God bless you. We'll see you again next Sunday.